today, Byron Saxton, alongside Hall of Famer, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is FCW TV, and folks, tonight, we understand Alex Riley, our Florida heavyweight champion, is going to have a very important announcement to be made on the Oksana Show. Also, tonight's main event, Florida Tag Team titles on the line, the Polynesian Power Pack combination of Donnie Marlowe and Brodus Clay will challenge Los Aviadores.
I tell you what, Byron, I kind of smell an upset coming here tonight. Los Aviadores been on the roll, but the Power Pack seems to be in control. I cannot wait to see Oksana after her award-winning show last week. She is so good. I can't wait to see that.
Well, there's a time for talking, and there's a time for action, and the time for action starts
right now.
Here on FCW TV, Trent Barretta, one half of the Dude Busters and one half of the former Florida Tag Team Champions.
And his opponent from Seattle, Washington, weighing 245 pounds, Jacob Novak.
Well, they say FCW is all about opportunity for up-and-coming superstars, and you could say very much so an opportunity for Jacob Novak.
You know what, Brian? I got to say right off the bat, I'm going to throw this out here. You've been there with me. American Dream Tour is going great across the state of Florida. I'm a little sore, I might add. But everything's going to be all right. Looking forward to seeing a great upside here with Jacob Novak. A real test for him tonight against Trent Barretta.
Absolutely. I mean, we'll talk more about the American Dream Tour
later
on this broadcast.
I know we will.
But, of course, Jacob Novak, what an upset it would be. What a victory it would be for Jacob Novak if he could pull one on Trent Barretta.
When you take a look at Jacob Novak, you see a big kid, young kid, trying to learn his trade right here. And a bottom line, upset would be upset of upset for him to beat young Trent Barretta.
Jacob Novak on a whim.
On a who?
On a whim, you know, sudden decision.
Where is your broadcast partner besides me? Abraham Washington at this point in time.
Well, I can't divulge all the information, but I understand from what I was told, Abraham was taking care of some intricate business, is what he told me.
All right.
He actually said, Saxon, I got some intricate business. That's what he told me.
I hear. Right here, that's a good reversal right there. Oh man.
Yeah, young kid. Novak heard the boot from Trent Barretta. A nice counter.
Byron, that boot really didn't get him too bad, and he came back on a great counter. That shit. Say hello to all my great fans here. Derek Brooke from the Bucks are here tonight.
They are?
Yes, I see everybody here.
I was saying earlier, Novak on a whim, packed his car, left his hometown of Seattle, Washington, headed down to Tampa, Florida, and earned himself a spot here in Florida Championship Wrestling.
We saw Novak in action a couple months ago, challenging Alex Riley. Quick cover here, challenging Alex Riley for the Florida Heavyweight Championship. Obviously came up short, but hey, this is a proving ground. This is where you get better each and every week in FCW, and certainly in there with Trent Barretta, Novak looking very impressive.
You know, talking about Alex Riley, he is looking impressive, talking about Novak, but talking about the Florida Heavyweight Champion, there's so much going on in his life right now with Cabal and Johnny Curtis and so many guys going after that Florida Heavyweight Championship. But he made a statement that I really like coming from that young man. He said, even though I'm at the NXT, and I'm up there on television throughout the world, and not only television right here. Bottom line is, that's a good shot right there. Bottom line is, I'm gonna continue to be the Florida Heavyweight Champion. And that's big.
You know, like him or not, he is our Florida Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, nice counter by Trent Barretta midair. Hooks the leg, no.
I tell you what, Jacob's pretty impressive going here. I mean, you know, kicks out at the right time, trying to get himself together, move up the ladder, become a star here at FCW. That moves you on to the pay window, you know what I'm saying?
Jeez. One of these men headed to the pay window, and right now it looks like Trent Barretta might be trying to inch a little closer. Series of forearms rocking Novak. Beretta one step quicker.
Man, Beretta, you know, when you talk about improvement, too, Beretta has really improved as a single. We've seen him in some great matches with one Alex Riley.
Now, whether it's Friday Night SmackDown or FCW, Beretta brings it full force every match. Wow! Springboard dropkick. Jacob Novak might be out.
Oh! Whoa! Maybe not. That's some fight left in this dog. That's some fight left here. That's good. That's good stuff, Jacob.
Novak's holding on, but all you got to look at is the expression on his face to see that he's not doing too well.
Yeah, but he has not been beat yet.
Beretta going for springboard tornado DDT, countered by Novak. A couple vicious kicks. Whoa.
Oh, man. Get a cover here, kid.
Seeing a more aggressive Jacob Novak here. Lateral press may capture victory now.
Good way to open up. What a night we got here. Place is packed. It's the middle of the summer. The tour's going on. Good looking girls from Florida everywhere. It's amazing.
And the American Dream.
Yes, right here.
And this time, Beretta connects.
I see it right there.
With the tornado DDT.
Nail
shoulders
it.
Down. Beretta on top. And he wins.
Here is your winner, Trent Beretta.
Well, Trent Beretta, despite being taken to the limit by young Jacob Novak, it's Beretta who captures victory. Take another look. You know, we saw Beretta go for that springboard tornado DDT earlier on. Novak had a counter, but the second time was a charm, and it's Trent Beretta headed to Dusty's apron.
That's it.
Well, folks, don't forget, main event later on tonight, the Florida Tag Team titles will be on the line. The Polynesian Power Pack combination of Donnie Marlowe and Brodus Clay will challenge Los Aviadores.
You know, Liviana, looking over this list of names, I've got to have a new general manager.
Yes.
You're the only one that was an assistant to both of the general managers prior. I don't see anybody on here that qualifies. I don't even see anybody here that I think would do a good job. You got any suggestions?
You know, Steve, I'll do whatever I can to help you find a new general manager. It would be my pleasure, really. Oh, I dropped my pencil. Excuse me.
Hey, Steve, I've got a great idea for a show. I wanted to...
Norman, this isn't what it looks like.
Man, I've been there, done that.
Hey, Mr. Kern.
Hey, Liviana. I hear you're looking for a new general manager, and I gotta say that Rudy Parker is ready for the job.
Good luck, President. We're out of here.
Get up. Man, that looked bad.
But I found the pencil. The lead's still in it. The following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Brooksville, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Bo Rotundo.
Well, welcome back to FCW TV. I'm not quite sure how to respond to what we just saw.
Well. I will just say this, Liviana is always in the wrong place, it looks like, at the right time for somebody to kind of make their own consumption about it, you know what I mean?
Maybe she surgically implanted the pencil into her hand.
Oh, man, too much.
And his opponent, from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing 231 pounds, Derek Bateman.
He calls himself one sweet dude in the eccentric style to match. Look at those trunks, Dusty.
Yeah, I tell you what, they put it loud, but these two athletes right here, they both have a shot at becoming FCW heavyweight champion. Bo Rotundo, both of them have moved up the ladder. They're great athletes. They're in great shape. This should be a great matchup. And just going back to what the President Steve Kern said, Byron, I hear that there's a new general manager on the hunt. I mean, I would actually vote for you.
You vote
manager.
For me?
Yes, I would actually go to Steve and say, listen, Byron, you'd be a great general manager if he wasn't such a great play-by-play commentator. Would at least, is that close?
Evenly matched, yeah. That's
yeah,
tough.
And he happens to be out there with somebody we both know that is very close to me and his pro. And a man that is dashing, a man that's body is cult and sculptured, as he tells me every day on the phone, young Cody Rhodes. But Bo Rotundo has got himself together. Yes.
A lot of.
Did I tell you Derrick Brooks was here? You know who else is here? The guy that sits on the front row at the jeez. That might have got him right there at the basketball game.
I think it did.
He's a movie maker. What's his name?
Where do you see all these people? I don't see them.
Bob Lee. Spike Lee. Spike Lee is here.
Yeah, well, those
Spike. Hey, Spike, what's up, bud?
To the chest of Bo Rotundo and a nasty-looking neck breaker by Derek Bateman on the edge of the ring going for the cover.
He's
here.
He's got him, too. This might be it. This is not an upset here. Either one of these men could win right here.
Derek Bateman, a very accomplished in-ring technician, as you're seeing before our very eyes. Don't let his antics outside the ring fool you. Overtone of that heart of fire, never say die attitude.
Man, this is what...
Recover here.
That's what FCW is all about, man. Well, Two young studs trying to get it done.
You see the aggression on the face of Derek Bateman, knowing that every chance you step inside that ring is a chance to prove yourself, is a chance to get noticed, to raise eyebrows.
That is so good. To get a chance, it's like almost a filibuster. A chance to get noticed, a chance to raise eyebrows, a chance to move up to what? The pay window. That's what it's all about, getting to the pay window. Me and LeBron James make the same amount of money.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, maybe. Let's go back to lunch sometime. Cover.
What, to lunch?
Well, the time is still in this fight.
Yeah. Abraham, why you won't even go to lunch with you?
I know, but I figured, you know, you and I are closer.
Yeah, we are. That's true.
Derek Bateman getting the best of Bo Rotundo thus far, but Bo keeps slipping out.
Schoolboy cover.
Bo Rotundo's motto, failure is not an option.
Now, question. Where did you find out that motto from?
Bo told you.
He said that.
Yes.
Yeah, no, he... I mean, he told you that. Bo said that.
Bo told me his motto was failure is not an option.
Like Titus O'Neil, just win, baby. Is that the same thing?
No, that's make it a win. That's,
oh, make it a win.
Yeah. Like self-mantras, you know, you use different quotes to inspire yourself.
I hear you. That's good stuff. Good matchup right here at FCW. Hope everybody's watching. Really appreciate all the support I'm getting on this. FCW's getting on this tour. It's really cool.
How is the tour going? I know you've had several dates all around the state of Florida.
Yeah, bobblehead and going everywhere. And, you know, you've been with me on so far, and I'm, you know, not finished yet. And, you know, going around seeing all the great fans around the state. Signing autographs, saying hello, kissing babies. Kissing babies' mamas.
Kissing babies' mamas.
Hey. I love it. That's good stuff. That's so good.
Bateman and Bo Rotundo trying to recover here. Bo just giving it all they've got. Bo Rotundo barely standing and still throwing those wild shots towards Derek Bateman.
Duck under right there.
And they're looking for momentum. Here he comes.
Oh, second win of the 20-year-old Bo Rotundo about to drive the head of Derek Bateman. No counter.
Slip him behind right there. It's a good move.
Second time around works.
Caught him up. Hook up that leg.
Oh.
Did not hook it. Did not even catch it. You know, on the blow of the head, did not get him well enough.
Bateman,
but he went for it.
Able to slide up the left shoulder just in time to save this match thus far.
Blockbuster like neck breaker, and this could be it.
I'll tell you what, we got a good matchup going here. Whoever the general manager is going to be down the future, one of these guys are in for a title shot, maybe.
Derek cannot let frustration get the best of him. He's gotten very close thus far. He's got to stay on Bo Rotundo. Going for a belly to back suplex. Bo still fighting.
Oh. Counters into a bulldog. And now it's Bo on top.
Showtime!
Jeez! Face first goes Derek Bateman, and he is out!
Here is your winner, Bo Rotundo!
Bo Rotundo said his motto is failure is not an option, and during this match, he would follow through despite the punishment, coming out victorious.
You know what's up next, though?
Well, I'll take another look. Before we get up to what's next stream, we thought Derek Bateman, I'm sure Derek Bateman thought he had Bo Rotundo right where he wanted him, going for that belly-to-back suplex. Bo Rotundo finding a way to counter
counter into a bulldog, and then look at this maneuver, driving Bateman's face, smash head on into the canvas and the cover.
Now what's coming up?
Now what's coming up? Okay, three. We're coming up next.
The hottest show on television.
The hottest show, critically acclaimed. I'm excited.
I'm excited too.
It's the Oksana Show.
Can I wait?
Special guest, Florida Heavyweight Champion.
I wonder who the musical host is going to be. I can't wait to hear.
Alex Riley. Yeah, we'll find out too.
Yeah, but I've been hearing limousines been pulling up. I can't wait.
And boys and girls, it's the Oksana Show. Tonight, Oksana's guest is NXT superstar and Florida Heavyweight Champion, Alex Riley. Tonight's musical guest, Tony Bennett. Now for Lithuania's hottest export, she's Oksana!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my second show, the Oksana Show. I'm so excited to tell you that my guest tonight is going to be music guest, Tony Bennett. And my first guest going to be Ali Rylix, Florida Heavyweight Champion.
Good to see you, Oksana.
You
know, the Tonight Show called me and I said I had prior arrangements already to be on your show, so thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank you for coming. Yeah. Thank you so much. But let me ask you, why are they calling you Universe Village?
Huh?
University Village?
Varsity Villain?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah.
You got it.
Well, the reason, honey, why they call me the Varsity Villain is because I'm the first ever educated Florida heavyweight.
You're funny. I like educated. That you're laughing with me. You're the first guest.
First guest to laugh with you. Well, that's a shame. I don't know why they wouldn't laugh
and
with
they
you.
Think that you mean. You don't look like mean at
no,
all.
No, I'm not mean at all. I'm the Varsity Villain. They're just jealous because I'm an educated champion, unlike my predecessors. Big word.
Let me ask you,
sure.
What kind of girls do you like?
What kind of girls do I like? Yeah. Well, tall, short, skinny, fat. I like them all. I like them all.
Do you like blondes from Lithuania?
Mmm.
Huh? Are you mean for real?
I mean, I'm not mean. You said I was nice.
Yeah, but mean. Lithuanian girls, you know, we are sweet. And... Anyway, okay. Let me see that. Oh, yeah. No, how do you call that
touch.
Thing?
How do I call this?
Uh-huh.
This is the Florida Heavyweight Championship. This is the Florida Heavyweight title. I worked a long time to get this, and this is not a toy or a little piece of jewelry, Oksana.
Oh, this is real.
Yeah.
All right, talking about Heavyweight Florida Champion, Caval, he was saying to everybody that he is Florida Heavyweight Champion.
Why is Caval saying that he's the Florida Heavyweight Champion? I have no idea why Caval is saying he's the Florida Heavyweight Champion. I beat him fair and square.
Oh, I'm sorry. My producer, Doug, we have a clip. Let's watch the clip.
Riley may be headed for sleep time.
Come on, Alex.
Caval holding up. Wait, what the? Alex Riley intentionally struck the referee.
Oh, he struck the referee. He did it, yes, but not on purpose.
And now it's Caval, once again.
What?
Riley's tapping.
Here's your winner, and new Florida Heavyweight Champion, Caval.
My God, we have a brand new Florida Heavyweight Champion.
Are you kidding me?
Ladies and gentlemen, due to a disqualification, Caval is the winner. However, the championship title does not change hands. Therefore, your heavyweight champion, Alex Riley!
Oh, Byron Saxton! Whoa, did you see that?
Uncanny resemblance. You know, look, if Caval thinks that he can carry this company and he's telling people that he's the Florida heavyweight champion, then I have something in store for him. I have a couple challenges for him because it takes a lot more than gymnastics to carry the FCW on your back. So in 2 weeks or 3 weeks, however long it takes, if Caval passes, let's call it the Alex Riley Challenge, I will give him another opportunity at the Florida Heavyweight title.
My producer, he's saying what? Tony Bennett? He's not coming. What?
Tony Bennett's not coming?
No.
That's the only reason I showed up for this show was Tony Bennett. God.
What?
Where's my agent? Tony Bennett's not... You know what? He's in San Francisco.
How come you
That's
know
where
that?
He is. He never leaves San Francisco.
You're right.
How did you get your own talk show?
Oh.
I can't believe it.
What, are we out of time? I'm sorry, Riley. Thank you so much for coming. And thank you so much to everybody watching my show. And like my grandma say, iki kito karto. Ata.
The following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 300 pounds, Shad Gaspar.
Well, Shad Gaspar has been walking around FCW with a chip on his shoulder the last few weeks, saying he doesn't feel like he's received the praise that he deserves.
Shad Gaspar is a bad man, and I'm going to tell you what, if he wants praise here, though, he's got to, you know what, he's got to earn it. He has to earn it. How about that show? How about that Oksana show?
That was interesting.
But she felt some controversy there with Cavall and all
Alex
that.
Alex Riley and Cavall, it's going to be very interesting what Alex Riley has planned for this Alex Riley challenge,
as
he called it.
And his opponent, from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing 245 pounds.
Johnny Curtis riding high back to basics. Last week, he earned the right to become the number one contender for the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
You know, one quick thing I want to say, Byron, is he did that. And, you know, young Mike McGillicuddy is still also, like Cabal is, laying claim to a victory in that aspect. So I think it's pretty cut and dry, but I don't think we've seen the last of McGillicuddy and Johnny Curtis.
I wonder if, we talked about how Shad Gaspar feels like he hasn't received the praise he deserves. I kind of wonder if he intends to take some of that aggression out on Johnny Curtis because Curtis has now become the number one contender.
Well, let me tell you what, if you're the number one contender in any sport or any entertainment or if you're the number one actor in the world and you're making more money than anybody else, you want to be the best, and you got to beat the best. That's another thing going way back to somebody we both know real well, but he's got to be able to bring it. If he does not bring it against Johnny Curtis, then he takes a step back away from the pay window, and when you get in that step back thing, it's harder to get them steps forward. I'm telling you that. This is a big outing for Shad Gaspar. Big outing.
I like how you say that.
With that, but I'm going to tell you what. With that good analogy of what?
I've never heard one better.
Every once in a while, I can come up with it. But Shad got to bring it. Shad Gaspar has got to bring it.
Johnny Curtis wisely focusing on the left arm of Shad Gaspar. And you look at Shad, a guy who's 6'7", 300 pounds. You take one limb and you break it down, and that's significantly going to reduce the offensive ability he has.
Yeah, and here's another thing about the ability. When Johnny Curtis, I really believe Johnny Curtis should already be up at NXT. Should have been on the first series. On the first, series. And now in series two, it's going on. And I think what he's lacking is one thing. If he can become the Florida heavyweight champion, there's no holding back. None. Zero. Nato of zero.
You see the reminder there, ominously in the background, Alex Riley, Florida heavyweight title.
Sometimes it's like a can of worms, you know what I mean, Byron? Sometimes it is. I know your dreams are to be Florida heavyweight champion. Put your picture on a poster. I'd love to see your picture on one of these banners.
I'd love to see it too.
Here, man. You know? Why you got a banner in here? Me hanging around or something, you know? That's
how quickly things change.
Excuse me. Hey, Spike.
Hey, who?
Spike Lee is here,
hey,
man.
Spike Lee isn't here.
Yeah, he plays with the New York Nets. Or the Knickerbockers.
He does?
Spike Lee, yeah, he does.
It must be a different Spike Lee.
No, it is Spike Lee sitting over there, man, with Derek Brooks and everybody.
Shad Gaspar draping the neck of Johnny Curtis over that middle rope.
I don't care about no Shad Gaspar right now. I'm talking about Spike Lee,
well,
big movie maker.
I want to get in the movies.
I want to get in the movies.
Just trying to do my job.
I want to play something like a Tom Cruise movie or something.
Yeah, I thought you said he was a player.
Who is?
Spike Lee.
No, man, he ain't a player. He's a movie maker.
Look at this maneuver. Shad Gaspar.
Well, there you go. He could, I mean, got to turn it on.
Arching the back of Johnny Curtis over his knee and thigh area. Look, almost ripping the mouth.
Yeah, and you know, I'm going to reiterate what you said when we come back from the Oksana show. Alex Riley making that challenge. So the next few weeks, we're going to see some type of challenges with Cabal. But, you know, right now, the number one contender's got his work cut out for him. Because Shed is trying to bring it to him here. Shed Gaspar. Shed Gaspar from Memphis, Tennessee. Where's Shed from?
He's from Brooklyn, New York.
I love that. Shed Gaspar from Memphis, Tennessee. Home of Elvis Presley.
Folks, let me take this opportunity to remind you that each and every week you can catch live FCW action here inside the FCW arena, especially during the summer months. 4535 Southdale Mabry is the address, as well as FCWWrestling.com for information on all our live events. And look at Johnny Curtis now.
Yeah, he's dealing now. This one brought Johnny to the dance right here. Big uppercut. Got the big man down. Shaq Gaspar is down from Tupelo, Mississippi, via Brooklyn, New York.
I like that. Back to basics, thoroughbred Johnny Curtis.
Oh, yeah. Well, that will stop something like that.
Now remember, that Shaq Gaspar does have the experience, perhaps the edge and experience over Curtis, who counters midair. No.
Yeah, Shaq's too big and strong. Got to do something bigger than that, make a bigger move than that.
Ronnie Curtis has faced the best of the best here in FCW since day one. Johnny Kick!
Johnny Kick right across the noggin. Two got him.
It's been some time since we've seen the Johnny Kick, but Shaq Gaspar, yes!
There you go. Here is your winner, Johnny Curtis!
Well, Johnny Curtis continues his trend, continues his momentum as the number one contender for the Florida Heavyweight Championship. Take a look again. Shaq Gaspar took it to Curtis, but all it took was one Johnny Kick, and Johnny Curtis heads to the pin window and looks the closer to receiving a shot at the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah, with the Johnny Kiss. That was a good one, man. Now I know why Abraham Washington wants to stay away from you. Johnny Kiss.
Oh, stop it. Folks, right now we're going to send things over to our broadcast colleague, Matt Marlero, who is standing by with the FCW Divas Champion, Naomi Knight.
All right.
I'm here with the FCW Divas Champion, Naomi Knight. Naomi, you've been successfully defending your title here in the FCW arena around the state of Florida. But Serena, whom you defeated in the tournament finals for that title, says she wants her shot. Not only that, AJ Lee, the queen of FCW, has staked her claim as next in line against your championship. What are your thoughts?
Well, I'm the champ, and I'm the champ for a reason. Getting the title was hard, and of course, keeping it is going to be harder. However, I have defeated Serena and AJ already, and I'm not intimidated or threatened by either one of them.
Good
so
girl.
I would love to show them up again.
Good
I don't
girl.
Have a problem with giving them another match, because I know I'm going to come out on top.
Well, Naomi, as the champion, you know that challenges are everywhere around the corner, so you've got to have high spirits right now. How are you doing? How are you doing around the state of Florida, defending that title night in and night out?
I'm loving it and enjoying myself. Hey!
Hey.
Naomi, thank you very much. What are your thoughts? Who do you think is the more deserving challenger at this point?
Neither.
I like it.
Neither? Not Serena, not AJ?
Neither.
Well, you heard it here from the champ. Neither challenger seems to be worthy opponent for Naomi Knight.
Oh, well, I think Serena has something to say about that.
Well, she took a time about getting out there. I mean, somebody talking about me, I'm getting out there.
In the midst of all this celebrating that you're doing, don't forget what I did to you weeks ago. And when I get a rematch with you, I promise I will take your title and I'll take the...
Whoa.
Oh, baby.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, here we go. Broke down.
We're not going to have to wait. AJ Lee. Oh, AJ trying to help out, trying to pull apart right here. Wow.
And the queen of FCW, thank goodness AJ Lee is out here.
Oh. We got a beatdown going here, buddy.
Serena.
Oh.
Taking this Diva Championship situation personally.
That's some bad blood running right here, boys. Let me tell you.
Somewhere we're going to see this matchup. And Serena has laid out the champion and sent a direct message
about her intentions.
AJ Lee just picked the title up right there, buddy.
Anyone that's seen that contest knows that he can lay claim to being the Florida Heavyweight Champion, much less one of the top contenders and runners in NXT. Make no mistake about it. The Warrior is the man, buddy. I guarantee you. Alex had some harsh words about him early on in the Oksana show. They're still trying to wonder what Serena was. Speaking of Alex Riley, isn't that him?
Alex Riley, look on his face. He mentioned some sort of Alex Riley challenge earlier on tonight on the Oksana show, and I suppose we're back.
You know, I told you, Cabal, if you want another shot at my Florida heavyweight title, you're going to have to earn it. Now, to earn it, I have set forth a series of challenges. The first one that's going to take place tonight, one that I'd like to call the Giant Assassin versus the Midget Cab Driver. Ladies and gentlemen, standing over 7 feet tall, weighing over 300 pounds, Jackson Andrews.
Whoa. Oh, buddy, you talk about a challenge, outweighed by 200 pounds almost. He's more than 300, I guarantee you that. And over 7 foot tall, and this is your first challenge? What's up with that?
The Giant Assassin, as Alex Riley referred to Jackson Andrews, kicking off what we now know as the Alex Riley Challenge, which is an opportunity, if you can call it that, for Cabal to finally earn a shot at Alex Riley's Florida Heavyweight Championship.
I tell you what, I call it an opportunity to get hurt.
That's what I call it. One more thing, Cabal. Good luck.
That was nice. Well, Cabal, whatever strategy he had in mind, certainly have to regroup. Taking on a man twice your size.
Well, he's quick. I know that. Yeah, that's the way to break him down right there.
And he's going to have to be quick. You cannot get caught in the unforgiving hands of Jackson Andrews.
This is a real interesting contest right here. I guarantee you that.
Strikes by Cabal trying to bring the big man down. And uh-oh.
Whoa, baby, look at the power. Look at the power.
The strength, the domination by Jackson Andrews attacking Cabal.
Alex Riley still at ringside, kind of moving around there. You got to keep your eye on him, but this could end the challenge tonight. Cabal's hopes of being Florida Heavyweight Champion could be over tonight, right with this. Done deal.
You look at the road that Cabal has traveled down. He's had three knee surgeries. Constantly the underdog. He knows what it's like to be told you can. He knows what it's like to have the odds stacked against you. But my gosh, right now being treated like a rag doll by Jackson Andrews.
I tell you what, FCW Universe is behind this young man, Cabal the Warrior. But Jackson Andrews is a huge, huge man.
This all stems from a split decision of sorts a few weeks ago on an FCW Live event. Cabal was thought to have won the Florida Heavyweight Championship.
I was there. I thought it happened too. Referee made a great call, though, when you go back and look at it. The replay tells it all. Alex Riley deliberately got disqualified, period.
And now Alex Riley obviously wants no part of Cabal. Trying to do whatever he can to stop Cabal in his tracks.
He hit him with that kick right up beside the head, and he just didn't
even
hold
sure.
It.
Yeah,
the
man just grazed Jackson Andrews. Obviously trying to shake off the cobwebs. Can Cabal capitalize?
Oh! Well, he'll light you up, I know that, and he won't back down. There's no fear here. Yeah. Well, I tell you what, like I said, ain't it funny how time slips away, how that Florida challenge slips away from one Cabal, the Warrior right here.
Right into the size 22 boot of Jackson Andrews, and now Caval.
Caval trying to get him hooked up.
Oh my gosh! Caval's got the arm locked of Jackson Andrews. Andrews
look at
trying
the
to shake
strength.
Him off.
Oh man!
Caval
got the arm
on.
Still.
Rolls him off. Come
he got him. He got him. I can't believe it. He got him.
Here is your winner, Caval.
Wow!
Holy mackerel! Alex Riley has gone insane.
Alex Riley's shot did over Jackson Andrews.
Is that big or what?
Well, I guess it's safe to say part one of the Alex Riley challenge has been accomplished.
Well, Alex better watch out here.
Don't blame the Giant, Alex. Blame Caval.
Wow, and the Giant looking. The Jazz catching a big look here at Alex.
Folks, we've been talking about it all night. Our main event is next. Four of the tag team titles on the line. Ken Moss Aviadores retain successfully as they defend against Brodus Clay and Donnie Marlowe.
Hey, Spike, maybe some of that popcorn you got. Spike Lee over there, my man, got some popcorn.
The following is a tag team match set for one fall, and it's for the Florida Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, the challengers, Brodus Clay and Donnie Marlowe.
A tag team turning a lot of heads in FCW. Only thing is, all those heads are turning in the opposite direction because they're afraid to be dealt with.
Donnie Marlowe got all the skills to be a champion of any kind. And now with Big Brodus Clay, unorthodox looking that he is, big, mean, and powerful, former bodyguard from the Snoopy Dogg himself.
Luchadores, Los Aviadores have had their run-ins with the Polynesian Power Pack, and perhaps Donnie Marlowe and Brodus Clay looking to avenge the loss of their brethren, the Usos.
They're what? They're brethren. They're friends.
That's some big words, man.
That's
I mean,
right.
That's really big, man. That's addiction. That's Harvard stuff.
It's summertime.
That's Harvard school.
We gotta learn.
Reverend. I'm gonna use that.
You're my brother.
My
commentary brother.
Yeah, we're brethren.
Folks, this is our main event, Florida Tag.
I wonder how
titles.
Serena feels about beating up on Naomi there, man.
Well, it goes to show you not just as
well,
far as the
the
male athletes here in FCW, but the Divas as well. It's all about the Divas Championship and doing whatever you can to make a statement.
I hope Naomi is all right. Naomi just used all the breath she had. If Naomi, you know, Serena summed it out and commenced to beat on her, threatened to cut her hair. Brodus Clay got some interesting tights on. Trunks. Breeches.
Yes.
His breeches got a world map on the back of them.
Is that what it is?
But I'm going to tell you what, these guys are dangerous. I'm talking about Marlowe, as you know, and Brodus Clay.
Well, Donnie Marlowe, for a long time, talked about how he felt very underutilized in FCW, how he felt he wasn't given a fair share. So what did he do? He went ahead and found Brodus Clay, went ahead and aligned himself with the Usos, and here you see Donnie Marlowe now, perhaps after tonight, could be one half of the tag team champion.
I'm just going to say that. No matter 1, 2, 3, this thing has already elevated him into, I wasn't getting a shot, and now I am. But now I'm the Florida tag team champion. Los Aviadores are flyers. That's what the word Los Aviadores means. They are brethren.
Both right of them are brethren. That's Unico in there. Nice roll up.
They're both brethren to each other. That's so quick and fast. Look at that.
Whoa!
Man. Into a hip toss, these guys off the hook.
Unico.
They on my tour, you know.
Well, they are a lot of FCW stars appearing on the American Dream Tour.
Yeah, but if you're from the Latin community and you want to see some luchadores, you need to jump on this tour.
Luchadores.
I guarantee you. No, I can't drink right now, Spike. Thank you, bud.
What are you talking about?
My man over here.
Tag made to Epico. Tag to Milver Springboard. Wow! Jeez. Cover.
Springboard into a neck roll, got him down.
Tell you,
Big Brodus Clay, you know, he said mile for mile on his types of something. 1 mile to a next mile. He needs to get tagged in.
Well, I think he must have heard you because Brodus Clay has just been tagged in.
Yeah, this man can hurt somebody right here. This man can hurt somebody.
The immovable force of the Polynesian Power Pack in there with Unico, and I'm not sure that's going to work too well.
No, not when you grab a tree trunk.
Oh. Tell you, Brutus Clay and Donnie Marlowe like to refer to themselves as the Colossal Connection in honor of the former legendary tag team mate of Haku, Donnie Marlowe's father, as well as the legendary Andre the Giant.
Well, I think that's really cool, man. That's the way to go. I mean, they got to prove themselves. We have opportunity knocking on them door, their door, not them doors, they doors, to become
here comes Unico, watch out, full speed, and gets draped over the top rope.
That was just power move right there.
And you can't blame Unico. I mean, they've got to utilize their speed against a guy, nearly 400-pound Brutus Clay, but you can't substitute power.
No, you can't. You really can't. I think Marlo made a great choice there right here, you know, because the Usos are obviously all tied up. Yeah, this is good stuff. Oh. Throwing him around like a rag doll. He ragdolled him. What we call ragdolling. That's what's happening.
You can see the confidence, the intensity from Brutus Clay, knowing he is in full control at this moment.
Uh-oh. And the big forearm elbow to the mid-rib. That'll make your back crack, your liver curl, your knees freeze. That also will make your back crack, your liver curl, your knees freeze.
It's a very basic strategy you're seeing from Brutus Clay, to use his size to weaken Unico.
Standing room only in here. It's good stuff. All my buds are here, man.
Nice tag team continuity by Marlowe and Clay. Marlowe, no small man by any accord. Very thick and powerful.
Wow. Here you go, buddy. Could put him away. Oh. New Florida Tag Team Champions could be crowned right here tonight.
Diving headbutt. Epico gets a shot for his pleasure.
Sure. Trying to get in. Ref doing a good job staying with him. Big headbutt. I'll call it. Big headbutt.
That's good. Okay, Marlowe and Clay complement each other so well. Tagging in and out, keeping the freshman in, and continually attacking Unico, wearing down one half of the Florida Tag Team Champions.
I think they kind of rub off each other, though, when you talk about the brethren, when you talk about the youth souls and these guys, the power pack. I think it's an amazing stuff.
Again, the power advantage, too much.
Man. We got it. We got new champions right here.
No cover here. Don't count Unico out yet. He's barely getting the shoulder up.
Referee without a position, and that cost them that,
well,
a
you know, hey, they better thank the referee, because we might have had new tag team champions. FCW Arena firmly in the corner of Los Aviadores as Unico desperately has got to get out of this predicament, desperately has to make the tag to a fresh Epico on the apron.
I tell you what, I'm pretty impressed here with Brutus Clay.
Modified gut buster by Clay, who goes for the cover. And think about it. You see Clay drive the gut of Unico into his knee. Remember, earlier on in this match, Brutus Clay was throwing Unico into separate corners, using all his weight, smashing up against his lifeless body. And now, just to add insult to injury, it's a wonder that Unico is even able to hang into this match so far.
Well, Unico got to be able to tag out and get a fresh guy in here. We need some speed and lightning here. We need what they're noted for, flying. Los Aviadores. That's what it is.
As long as this continues, we're not going to see any flying.
No, we could see new Florida Tag Team Champions right here. Fans, you just need to stay tuned. You need to be here in the audience. Turn your television on. Watch all this action. It's amazing here at FCW. Their Master Dream Tour is going around the state of Florida with yours truly.
Here you go. Pushing. Pushing. Yeah, reaching. And again.
Good move. Donnie Marlowe doing a good job.
Every time you think Unico can finally make his way to his partner, he gets driven back to the opposite corner of Clay and Marlowe.
Here come big Brutus Clay back in there. They made songs about this guy, brother.
Uh-oh. I wonder,
caught him on the arm. Didn't get him on the head. Caught him on the arm.
The chance. Direct path.
Here you go.
The tag is made.
Oh.
In comes Epico. Trying to go 2-0, gets the Polynesian power pack. Cover.
Watch out here. Here we go. Los Aviadores.
Keeping the speed. Here comes Marlowe. There goes Marlowe. Brutus Clay dazed, charged in. Meet the boot.
Whoa!
Wow, got him rolled up. He needs to get a cover right here. Hey, wait,
the Usos!
Well, Polynesian Power Pack is out there. Whoa, man, they got them both together.
We know.
Watch out. Watch out.
You got to be kidding me. Tamina.
Whoa.
High splash reminiscent of her father, Jimmy Snuka, on the tag team champions. And the Polynesian Power Pack is out in full force.
Amazing.
Here are your winners as a result of disqualification. Loss of Aviadore.
Well, Donnie Marlowe and Brodus Clay seem to be inching their way to capturing the Florida Tag Team titles, but thank the Usos and this invasive statement from the Polynesian Power Pack, and it makes you wonder, are the days of Los Aviadores numbered as the Florida Tag Team Champions? Folks, for myself, Byron Saxton, he's a dream. I'll see you next week.
Until next week, then, this would be Gordon Solie saying so long from the...